of 200 units that was literally going in right next door to the church. So as we talked through these things, we decided, well, what if we actually developed your green space in a more intentional way to be a community park for these residents that are going to be moving in next door? And so that's the direction we decided to take things. And y'all, I will tell you, it's super fun. I worked in real estate development for many years, still do to an extent. And I loved calling that developer and saying, hey, I'm calling from the church next door, and we actually want to talk to you about how we can put like a pathway between your property and the church property for residents to be able to use this space. Like, blow someone's mind. It was so fun. Because I will tell you, developers are so used to getting the calls of, what are you doing here and how do we keep you out, you know? And so to open that door in such a different way was so amazing. And I was like, yeah, this is what it means to be the church, right? And so where that landed is they ended up putting together a landscape plan. And as you can see, kind of the north end of that plan there is that property line is where the affordable housing units are. And they have a stormwater pond that's going in with city stuff, but they're putting in a walking path. They're putting in community gardens and some different access points along the edge of their property so that residents that are north of them can come and use the property. So that's a little bit bigger of a scale, working towards that kind of community park. And these examples really are just the tip of the iceberg. I mean, there are so many things, and I feel like I'm just like rushing through this because I got 15 minutes and my countdown's going. But there are churches that have, you know, community pizza ovens, brick ovens. There's a church in my neighborhood that does, you know, bread making Thursday in their outdoor oven, and people from the community can come and bake their bread. Another thing that is getting very popular are dog parks, which feels a little ridiculous in some ways, but I will tell you that dog parks are the modern day watering hole. I mean, that is where people meet each other and make friends. And if the church wants to build relationships, I say, you know what, maybe dog parks is the way to go. So Westminster Church, this is in Dallas area, a Methodist church, they have a community dog park. And it was really interesting because people get very nervous about liability with things like that. And I called them up and said, hey, talk to me about this dog park and, you know, kind of what have you had to do to make sure you're covered? And she was like, oh, we added like a rider to our insurance plan that was like $250 a year and that was it. And I was like, oh, so there you go. So dog parks. And then too, you know, thinking about churches that are more in some rural areas, having some of those things like community labyrinths, prayer labyrinths, those types of projects, walking paths, those types of things I think can be really engaging in places where you have more land and more space to be considering. Oh, I got it. I got 30 seconds, but can I keep going? Sorry. The church parking lot, we got to address it. So unfortunately, it's a necessary thing, but we in the United States have Donald Shoup, he's a parking expert. He has estimated that we have 8 parking spots per car in the United States, and 30% of land in our cities is consumed by parking lots. So, not a very good use of space. Unfortunately, it is something that is needed in elements of where we are located. But again, are there more creative things that you can be doing with your parking lot? Whether that's hosting pop-up markets, having some sort of bike maintenance facility. I also always encourage people to think about doing bike rodeos. I don't know if y'all have those here. Being from Texas, bike rodeos were a thing, but also rodeos are a thing in Texas. So I don't know if they're called bike rodeos in other places. But effectively, they're courses that help kids learn bike agility and skills and all of that. Pickleball courts are becoming a big thing too. So again, are there ways that you can creatively use your parking lot? And y'all, there are many churches these days too that are really looking at the scale of adding affordable housing to their parking lots because they're finding, you know, we don't have as much need for some of these parking lots as we did previously. So what does it mean to potentially build affordable housing? I worked with a church in Minneapolis that did that with their parking lot, and the state of California actually just changed a bunch of zoning codes regarding churches and religious uses and parking lots so that people can fast track zoning for affordable housing. So these, I think that's it. will hopefully whet your appetite. Again, I'm sorry it was kind of a fire hydrant at you, but I would also at this point say, they've mentioned it a couple times today, but the Embedded Church podcast, it's a podcast that I co-host with Eric Jacobson, and we do a lot of storytelling with churches across the country that are engaging in these types of ideas with their properties. And thinking about what it means to be embedded in their community. So give that a listen. That'll give you also a lot more ideas around some of these things. So I'll stop there.
I think I might still have the ribbon from the bike rodeo I did when I was 6 years old. I was so good going through those cones. It was great. Actually, great outreach effort there. So many ideas. I know you're hearing these things. You're thinking, wait, we could do that. Or wait, that's given me something new to think about. And that's what this session is going to be, a chance for you to kind of do some of that brainstorming. And I love the lead question. Facilitators, don't skip over that lead question. Don't let the ideas just come pouring out first. Think about your own experiences of where you felt hospitality. Where places you've gone and what those things were that contributed. And then let's start sharing some of those ideas and learning from each other as we go out to our breakout rooms. And we'll see you in a little bit.